nerd. He's the angry Atari Sega nerd.
This is bull.
Living in the sunlight, loving in the moonlight, having a
wonderful time. No!
Alright, let's dig into a big pile of bat. As you can see, I'm already. Because in order to play Batman games and do them just such, you gotta be Batman.
I'm Batman.
Let's start with Batman the Caped Crusader for the Koch 64. This game came out 4 years before the Tim Burton movie, which makes it the only game on our list that's game. You get a choice to fight against the Penguin or the Joker, but both games seem to be identical. I never really got far enough to find out. Every time you exit a screen, another panel pops up, and another panel pops up,
and another panel pops up,
and another panel
pops up.
Pops. I guess they were trying to make it look like a comic book, but it's just awkward. The first enemies you encounter are what I think are
Batman.
The control is wee. As you can see the instruction manual explains it. To do different kicks and kicks, you have to hold the joystick in a certain direction while hitting a button. It's also ridiculous, but you have to be like a step away. No matter how many times you hit somebody, they don't
die.
Oh, the keypad's busted. Oh.
You've got mail.
Goodbye.
Well, anyway, the game sucks. Gotta give it the Batman punishment. A Batman.
Next is the one which most people know. Batman on the SNES. Overall, when it comes to games, The Dark Knight's been treated a lot like because there do exist Batman games, and this is one of them. The graphics are dark and
suck.
Just like the movie it represents, and the music is addicting.
And so I wake in the morning and I step outside and I take a deep breath and I get real high and
Batman.
Holy
jump button.